mohon maaf. Itu permohonan maaf secara terbuka Wee Meng Chee.
The cabinet has rejected student Wee Meng Chee's apology for the furor caused by his Negaraku rap video clip, which had appeared on YouTube.
The fact that he has already apologized through my office and through his father and through MCA local leaders who know his parents, openly regretting his action, I think we should accept in good faith.
Use his apology as a reason not to persecute him is not on at all, because he has committed an offense against the nation.
Negara ku ni kalau kita dah abaikan, jadi mana tadi kita tak payah duduk Malaysia lah. Kalau India balik India, Cina balik Cina, Melayu balik ke tanah Jawa boleh. Ah, itu pada saya lah. Itu negara punya momen tau. Itu sokongnya kedaulatan, negara kita kedaulatan.
Raja kita selamat bertakhta.
Memanglah pasal kita memang anak dengan saya, memang tak ada hari tu nak tak sangkalah.
Wami issued that joint statement with other groups in response to the name Wee situation because we believe that almost amounts to a political witch hunt. I mean, we need not to agree with whatever name Wee express, and we are open. We are critical of some of the contents, but I think the whole point here is that what you need is public discussion. It's not, you know, a high hand suppression by the states. I mean, if what he say is wrong, let us tell him, you know, straight to the face and say now why this is wrong. If we think that he is incapable of argue rationally, then we should be better than him. By silencing him is basically saying that we are not better, we are no in any way better than him, and therefore we cannot argue, and we can only resort to silence him.
Obviously, it was an overreaction in the response. So when we came up with the statement, we also saw, you know, if sometimes you can understand when, you know, the government responds to politicians and say, ah, this is seditious. So you can see some political competition there. But who is this person? You know, he's studying in Taiwan. He's, you know, enjoying himself. He's got a creative idea. He's a little, maybe he's frustrated, maybe he's not. I mean, we are just making that assumption. He just wants to make a song about, you know, using the national anthem and turn it into a rap. And I don't think we even need to discuss whether it was a good rap or a bad rap, a good representation of the anthem or not, because that's really his right to do it.
Kalau kita betul-betul marah dengan apa satu karya seni itu, then kita express, kita keluarkan hujah kita. Kita challenge karyawan tu to an open debate. Karyawan ni pun suka kalau orang bagi feedback. Saya sebagai artis suka kalau orang bagi feedback. Kalau dia suka atau tak suka. You know, asalkan you stick to the point, you don't make personal attacks, you don't threaten to kill the person or hit them or apa. Saya rasa okey kalau kita nak marah. Banyak benda saya marah.
It's art. You know, just because you don't listen to it doesn't necessarily mean it's not art. You know, it's poetry. It's poetry on a beat, man. And it's exactly that, to be honest with you. And I don't listen to Betty Irama Malaysia, man. But doesn't mean I don't accept it as a music style or an art form. Just because I don't like it doesn't mean it's not there or present, right? So I feel like, man, although it is still very, very, very at a very early age, hip-hop in Malaysia, but I feel that we've made our presence felt enough to be taken seriously already.
Thank you. ordinary Malaysians have been asking questions. Does the federal constitution protect us all? Where are the legal remedies for individuals caught in these situations? Shyamala's case brought home the point that the constitutional role of the Civil High Court as the protector of the rights of the ordinary citizen was fast becoming illusory. The implications of this case, however, became the rallying force that drew together a small number of concerned NGOs and members of civil society. By May 2004, Shyamala's case had given life to a coalition of NGOs which has come to be known as Article 11.
Umum mengetahui bahwa kes Azlina Jani akan diputuskan oleh mahkamah pada keesokan hari. Kes ini sangat menarik perhatian yang dibuat berbagai pihak, khasnya dan umat Islam khasnya, kerana ia berkemungkinan memiliki kesan yang besar pada kedudukan Islam dan perlembagaan yang mudah di Malaysia.
Organizations and associations which are religious based in Malaysia, I would like to begin by praising Allah, praising God for His grace and mercy that the court has taken this position today. We welcome and applaud this decision by which we fully believe that justice has been served.
There's a lot of talk and about, you know, whether freedom of expression can be limited or not, or whether there are, you know, norms and rules and laws that govern freedom of expression. But let's go back to the very idea of freedom itself. Now, freedom is an absolute term. You're either free or you're not. You know, you're not half free or semi free. You're either free or you're not free.
Jadi saya kira kebebasan bersuara memang satu prinsip yang jelas sebahagian daripada ajaran Islam. Tetapi kebebasan yang berprinsip, ada panduannya, bukan kebebasan mutlak atau sewenang-wenang. Sebab dalam Islam kita tidak, kita berpegang kepada fahaman, pegangan bahawa manusia ini tidaklah bebas untuk melakukan apa saja mengikut apa yang dia suka.
There are always limitations on freedom of expression. Okay. Nobody is saying that freedom of expression is unlimited. That would be naive and stupid. It's just a question of degree, right? And in Malaysia, the degree is very, very high with regards to the suppression of expression. There are too many laws around which can be used to curtail freedom of expression.
Sensitive issues. Because some people say we shouldn't question these issues. Dia kata sebab benda ni dah terap dalam masyarakat. So kalau kau address, dia akan spark emotional response.
Some people yang dia boleh sedar dengan diri sendiri, dia boleh berfikir. Dengan cara itu dia akan membuat apa yang dia rasa diri dia betul. Dan dia akan mempersoalkan benda tu setiap hari kepada pihak-pihak lah. Tak kisahlah benda tu, no, benda tu, adakah benda tu memang dah konkret betul atau tak, tapi dia still nak perusahakan dan dia mahu jawapan daripada benda tu.
Aku lahir ke dunia dengan suara, dengan minda yang selalu bertanya, memikir setiap yang terjadi, tapi sentiasa dihalang dalam mencari erti.
When there is censorship of ideas, be it in terms of books, in terms of films, songs or whatever, it will mean that there is lack of freedom of expression. And you'll find that in Malaysia, Islam is controlled in terms of the kind of Islam that is trying to be promoted. And you'll find that the control is not, is something, one, it's exercised by the government. Two, it's not just government that exercises control over Islam and the kind of Islam that it wants to promote. You'll find that there are civil society organizations as well in Malaysia who are trying to control the definition of certain issues with regard to Islam.
Sebuah kerajaan yang bertanggungjawab mengikut perspektif Islam memang harus berperanan untuk mengawal kebebasan bersuara sekadar yang perlu. Ini berbeza dengan fahaman kebebasan bersuara Barat. Kebebasan bersuara Barat dia mutlak. Dia maksudnya benda yang tak baik ke tak baik, baik tak baik ke, biarkan beredar. Let the people choose themselves. Apa yang dia nak baca, apa dia tak nak baca, apa dia nak tengok, apa dia tak nak tengok. Itu Barat.
Look at the number of books that have been banned in Malaysia. Look at the number of attacks, public attacks on human rights activists, intellectuals, academics like myself, who have been accused of everything from blasphemy to insulting Islam to being a threat to Malay dominance. So these are actually on the rise. Book banning is on the rise. More books are banned in Malaysia every month.
Jadi kalau kata ban buku, pastikan buku yang betul-betul perlu ban. Ada private personal interest, ada ataupun group interest. Buku tu kebetulan memang kritik kita semata-mata. Tak boleh. Ha.
Kita, culture kita dalam bila membesar dekat Malaysia ni kan, biasanya our parents, datuk nenek semua, bila kita tanya soalan, kadang-kadang dia say, jangan soal, ikut je.
Memang orientation lah, pada rumah lagi, yang tu lebih kecil.
Daripada rumah macam tu.
Bergantung pada tujuan kita tanya soalan. Kalau kita tanya soalan macam nak minta pengetahuan dia kan, kalau kita jawab itu dah salah lah. Contoh kita interview orang tu, kita minta pendapat dia, memang kita perlu. Macam kita punya pencarah ke depan majalah ini, kita tanya soalan dia, dia tak jawab, tak bolehnya tu. Dia tak boleh cakap, this is my right, itu yang tak boleh. So bergantung pada kita tanya soalan, kita nak, kalau kita just tanya sama pasal something issue, current issue yang timbul, tu dia tanya, it's up to him lah.
Up to him.
Unless dia ada berkepentingan, ada perlu dia nak jawab benda tu, ada faedah pada dia sendiri lah. Memang orang boleh nampak lah, dia memang berkepentingan lah. Dia betul, selfish lah maksudnya. Betul. Sebab kita tanya, sebab penting kita nak korek pada dia. Dia yang, mungkin dia yang tahu pasal benda tu, dan benda tu penting untuk kita semua. Dia tak boleh tak jawab. Kalau dia tak jawab,
dia tak nak share.
Orang boleh pandang serau kat dia lah. Betul. So, public boleh.
It's valid for us to feel something.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, it's valid. No doubt.
Setiap kali ku menggorak langkah, senantiasa disekat, dihalang, ditegah. Bagai anak yang tak dilayan, tak diambil endah, dia kan pasti memerontak, itu hanyalah fitrah.
The tendency is for certain self-appointed groups to say, you have no expertise in this, so you cannot talk about it. Where? Where does it say that we cannot talk about it? All right? What authority do you have to impose on other people what we can or cannot discuss? All right? Where do you get your authority from to impose on other people what we can and cannot discuss? Just because I don't have a beard and just because I don't work for Abim doesn't mean I cannot talk about religious matters if I wanted to.
When you say who can speak for Islam or who should speak, who cannot speak, siapa yang boleh, sebenarnya tengok apa yang dia nak cakap. Kalau dalam bentuk seolah-olah bagi fatwa lah, atau bercakap tentang hukum, then sepatutnya hanya orang yang layak, yang ada qualification lah. Tapi saya kira sebenarnya di Malaysia ni, kalau merujuk ke situasi Malaysia, kalau tengok, kalau kita kata bahawa media ni banyak di sensor berkenaan dengan isu agama ni, anda rasa, saya rasa tak begitulah. Saya rasa media masa sangat bebas memberi ruang kepada macam-macam jenis orang untuk cakap apa saja yang mereka nak tentang Islam di Malaysia ni, sehingga timbul macam-macam kekeliruan. Cuma of course bila ada seorang dua yang melampau, kalau tak kerajaan, pihak-pihak pertubuhan-pertubuhan Islam ke menegur, biasalah tu. Tapi nak kata daripada awal lagi dia tak boleh buka mulut dia, I don't think so. Macam-macam benda pelik-pelik pun we have to kita terpaksa tahan telinga kita atau tengok macam-macam yang dicakapkan tentang Islam. Ngarut-ngarut banyak.
Religious matters, why some people say, you know, only experts can talk about it, because like even if you are medical, you're in the medical field, doctors, they specialize in certain areas kan. So bukan any layman boleh cakap tentang how to make poison ke apa kan, because they are experts in that, so they have the right to say that because they have done their research. Tapi in religious matters ni macam mana? Does it?
I think everybody has the right to say something.
Yeah, they has the right, but itulah tengok dia nak cakap. Tengok
but probably all the views might be different.
Dia kena ikhlas lah.
Tiada sebab untuk menunjuk bagus. Tiada sebab perlu keris dihunus. Sifat asabiah seperti jahiliah. Untuk menunjuk gagah, sanggup berpecah belah, pecah belah. Kata-kata senang sangat dikeluarkan. Retorik semata-mata di pasar telan. Kafir mengkafir, haram mengharam. Tuduh menuduh, takkan mereka tenang tidur malam.
Belakang sikit dia, Mike.
Religion is both a private and public matter. That is the nature of faith, of any kind of religious conviction, of any religion. You know, there's absolutely nothing wrong with bringing religion into the public domain. But if you want to use religion, your religion, as a platform for your engagement in the public domain. In other words, if you bring your religion into the public domain and make that the basis of your politics, and you want to change that public domain on the basis of your religion, now, the price to that is, once it enters the public domain, it should be open for everyone to discuss. If you don't want people to discuss your religion, don't bring it into the public domain. But if you want to force your religion into the public domain, then, by definition, and by extension, you expose it to public inquiry. So, of course, bringing Islam into the public domain, making Islam a political ideology in the public domain, means it affects everyone, Muslims and non-Muslims. And everyone has the legitimate right to question this.
Kena tengok bagaimana isu-isu ini disentuh. Kalau disentuh dengan cara yang sesuai, the right, you know, context, in the right setting, saya kira tak ada masalah untuk kita berbincang. Ya. Tetapi kalau dikemukakan dalam setting yang tidak sesuai, dalam dengan nada yang sudah begitu bias, ya, dengan nada yang sudah terlalu menjeblah, one-sided, mempertikaikan. Kalau mempersoalkan tu benda yang memang ajaran yang sekali contohnya dalam agama yang memang dah jelas-jelas definitif yang pasti yang established dalam agama yang tak orang lain tak pernah pertikaikan, tiba-tiba ada orang datang cuba nak pertikaikan juga, then it's problematic.
And why should people, I mean, if you feel that you are better, you have better knowledge, why should you be afraid? It goes back to the questions of how far you have confidence in the religions. Now, I have full confidence in this religion, even though I'm not a Muslim. And therefore, I believe that this religion can withstand any public, can withstand any public discussions. It would not be tempted at all. I mean, if you have the same amount of confidence as I do, you should feel very secure. I mean, can truth become falsehood simply because people bad mouth about it? No way. But of course, if you don't have that freedom, you don't have that confidence, of course you have a problem.
Okay. I mean, I think survey kan, banyak orang dia tak nak jawab survey tu. Sebab apa? Dia mula-mula dia kata okey.
Dia
sebab aku ingat Syah
mungkin kan? Sebab dia rasa benda ni isu sensitif, dia cuba nak menjauhkan diri.
Mengelak avoid.
Siapa yang cakap? Dia yang rasa
sendiri keraguan dalam diri.
Keraguan. Siapa yang terapkan keraguan tu dari kecil lah.
Dari kecil benda ni sudah
memang sensitif lah itu ya. Benda sensitif tu.
Benda macam ni telah disampaikan dalam bentuk yang tak boleh diterima. Ada sesetengah orang dia misinterpret this.
How we call it like a mindset.
The mindset from yeah. Negative thinking.
Untuk menjaga kepentingan diri sendiri, wayang kulit berulang kali kekal populariti. Siski tunjuk perang yang rasional ditenggelam. Asyik-syik mahu menang kebenaran kan karam. Perlakuannya tidak melambangkan agama. Cara yang salah tidak mengikut sunnah. Setiap perkara senang sangat dipertikaikan. Terpekit terlolong tanpa mengenal kebenaran.
What you get is that anything and everything is now being classified as or potentially as sensitive. There's no guideline. Not that I want a guideline or anything, but I'm saying that it's really so discretionary. So here's a big wall of everything. It's a graffiti of everything that could potentially be problematic. And we really have to break that wall. And in order to do that, we have to first accept the fact that, you know, we have to be different from one and another. We have to be different. We have to have different ways of thinking. And that not everyone is going to accept that, you know, Islam Hadari is the way of life. Not everyone has to accept that this is an Islamic nation. Not everyone has to accept that all Hindus need to have a temple. I mean, these are different things, and we have to be very, very honest with ourselves. I think a problem with Malaysia is that we've not been able to address some of the ghosts of our past, you know. And it's really time for us to do that because, you know, everything is potentially explosive, but what is really the thing that we want to achieve? We can't stop people from calling names. We can't stop people from feeling that I'm more, you know, I feel less, you know, appreciated in this country. But I think we really have to be honest with ourselves, and that's what we are not. We are not honest with ourselves. And we have to stop this Malaysia Truly Asia advertisement. I think that's the first thing that we have to get rid of, you know, because under the surface, there's so many things that we have to really talk about, which we are not talking about.
You know, because dalam Islam yang I know is kita tak menyekat orang daripada cakap. You know,
yeah.
There must always be dialogue. We cannot shut anyone down, no matter what. You know, kalau dia cakap benda yang tak baik pada kita pun, kita soal dia balik.
Mm-hmm.
You know, why you saying this? You know, tapi kita jangan be too judgmental of him. Kemungkinan dia ada rasa, you know, some people ada rasa envy, marah, ataupun dia terpinga-pinga, dia tak tahu. So, but we have to explain the best that we can.
If you are interested in something, you learn it for yourself. You don't depend on other people to tell you what's right or what's wrong. You figure it out for yourself. You go out there, there are books to read, there are websites to surf, okay? And you go and learn for yourself, all right? That's what people should be doing, if you're interested. If you don't care, all right, then that's fine. You know, if all you want to do is catch the Saturday matinee and hang out with your pals and do your rap music or whatever it is that you want to do, fine, go ahead, man, rock and roll. That's your choice. Okay, but if you're interested in something, you do it. You do your own research. You learn. You have a brain. God gave you a brain. Use it.
Dengan suara, dengan minda yang selalu bertanya, memikir setiap yang terjadi, tapi sentiasa dihalang dalam mencari erti. Sentimen rakyat sering sangat diperalatkan untuk mencapai keuntungan. Si polan asyik bertelaga, siapa yang lebih Islam? Berhujah tanpa ilmu yang mendalam. Sampai bila lagi harus kita biar emosi bersemadi? Sampai bila lagi perlu isu disembunyi? Perlakuannya tidak melambangkan agama, cara yang salah tidak mengikut sunnah. Setiap perkara senang sangat dipertikaikan, terpekik, terlolong tanpa mengenal kebenaran. Di mana hilang budi bicara, bercakap tidak membawa mana, bertindak tanpa ilmu di dada. Genggam bara,
genggam bara.
Cabaran akan datang bila, bila masa. Setiap kali ku mengorak langkah, senantiasa disekat, dihalang, ditegak. Bagai anak yang tak dilayan, tak diambil endah, dia akan pasti memberontak, itu hanyalah fitrah. Untuk menjaga kepentingan diri sendiri, wayang kulit berulang kali, kekal populariti. Sikit-sikit tunjuk berang yang rasional ditenggelam. Asyik-asyik mahu menang kebenaran kan karam. Tiada sebab untuk menunjuk bagus, tiada sebab perlu keris dihunus. Sifat asabiah seperti jahiliah, untuk menunjuk gagah, sanggup berpecah belah, pecah belah. Kata-kata senang sangat dikeluarkan, retorik semata-mata dikpasa telan. Kafir mengkafir, haram mengharam, tuduh menuduh, takkan mereka tenang tidur malam. They speak what they know not, they don't know what they speak. They speak what they know not, they don't know what they speak. Blame it on man, don't blame it on Islam. Blame it on man, don't blame it on Islam. If they gonna shut us down, we coming up again. If they gonna shut us down, we coming up again. If they gonna shut us down, we coming up again. We coming up again, we coming up again. Again, again.
Ini sudah nyanyi-nyanyi, bukan bunuh orang ni, nyanyi sudah nyanyi pergi, betul tak? Kasih dia, macam kami kasih sikit sana, jangan macam nyanyi. Nanti sekarang ni manusia punya orang.
Kamu kan kena maafkan dia lah.
Maaf sana, kasih sikit, betul tak? Ini nyanyi sudah nyanyi, ada orang bula-bula bakau ini. Ini mana ya punya itu koki je punya. Benda-benda. Ini pun tak boleh juga, ini pun mama, ini maya, salam ya. Dia sok bakau macam, betul lah. Ya. Pun tak boleh juga. Pun makasih dia tahu lah, ingat jangan. Betul lah.
Ya, kira nasihatkan dia balik lah.
Kena dia balik. Tak boleh tarik. Ini sama Malaysia punya orang. Betul lah. Satu orang pun mau cari makan juga. Betul lah. Bula-bula punya kesan. Ini kasih dia sikit can ke macam. Betul lah. Satu orang boleh bikin salah. Macam du punya anak, dia pun boleh bikin salah. Satu orang jalan, memang ada satu hari dia jalan. Salah punya hat, tak boleh dah. Betul lah. Satu orang mau fikir-fikir macam lah. Tak tahu bukan dua pal salah, dia janik saya. Betul lah. Cakap jangan lain kali ini kasih itu, satu kali kasih itu satu. Lain kali ini macam, mau kasih tangkap sama dukang macam.
Ramam bagian.